It's Joe, your faithful host and co-founder of Command Control Power, the longest running Apple consulting podcast. In case you missed our birthday, we just celebrated our 10th anniversary this summer. That's a long time, especially in tech. That was before Marco, John, and Casey accidentally started a tech podcast. That was before Steve Jobs passed away and left Apple totally rudderless and foundering, never to release another successful product. Back then, we were talking about the brand new Mac Pro. No, not the new brand new Mac Pro, and no, not the one before that, but the one before that. For 10 years, we've been getting together each and every week to bring you epic tales of tech support and business management, and I'm pretty sure we've saved a lot of people a ton of time by sharing our struggles and solutions. We've also spent a ton of time on this show over the years. It takes a huge commitment to keep showing up every week. It takes effort, care, and attention to plan and outline shows, line up, interview guests, coordinate our schedules, edit the recordings, post the show notes, and produce the special perks like t-shirts for our patrons. I'm not complaining. I really love doing this, and I'm proud of what we've created. I'm also really grateful for the support we've received from the Apple consulting community, like Adagy, for example. Not only does Adagy make the number one tool we rely on every day to manage our fleets of Macs and support our clients, but they've been a huge supporter of this podcast. We're also supported by Watchman Monitoring and Tidbits Content Network, two more great tools we use to run our businesses. A few dozen other patrons also pledge their monthly support, some of whom have pledged more than $1,000 over the years. Thank you so much. So, all told, how much money do we make on each show? Collectively, the community has spoken, and they've decided these shows are worth about $75 each. So, here's the announcement. We're showing up for our patrons. Starting now, we're shifting our focus to the Patreon community. That means the newest shows will be posted primarily on Patreon. How do you get the latest episodes? Visit commandcontrolpower.com and click on support. Pledge monthly, and you can instantly subscribe to the weekly patron-only episodes right in your favorite podcast app. If you already support us on Patreon, log in there to get your special link and subscribe to the patron-only show so you don't miss anything. For now, here on the public show, we're featuring a classic episode hand-selected for you from our catalog of over 500 episodes, along with the occasional new episode. And remember, we're regularly releasing new content on Patreon, where you can join our community of supporters starting at just $15 per month, giving you access to the freshest content. We feature dozens of exclusive shows on Patreon where we speak a little more freely about how we make business decisions, navigate client relationships, manage our employees, and sometimes deal with mistakes and difficulties too. Plus, as a patron, you receive access to our entire back catalog where you can revisit classic episodes and learn from colleagues we've interviewed who've shared their own best practices. Visit commandcontrolpower.com and click support to pledge monthly on Patreon. We'd really appreciate your support, and we're confident your business will benefit from the wisdom of the community we've gathered there. Thanks for listening, and we hope you enjoy this classic episode of Command Control Power.
Now I can step out?
Yeah.
All right, are we live to the room? Yeah, that was pretty cool. So we did a live test recording or test live broadcast from the train on the way here. So as we're like careening down the tracks, Waples is listening from 30,000 feet.
Matthew over there. Yes.
So we are Command Control Power. For anybody who doesn't know, thank you for your support, for being here, for listening.
We're now in what, 262 shows just about, so long time.
Thanks to Justin Eskar, of course, our host here and his team for bringing the community together of Apple consultants. It's been a great opening day. I really enjoyed yoga in the morning. That was a really awesome feature this year. I hope it's a repeat thing. A lot of people were there. It was a great turnout, actually. It was really, really impressive.
Jerry wasn't, but
Jerry ran, so that still counts. And then to kind of like roll into the work-life balance thing, I think that was a really, really cool back-to-back. You had a couple segments, and it was awesome. Thanks to our listeners, as I mentioned, our patrons, of course, and for everybody, a lot of faces here today. Thank you so much for being here. I guess to kick it off, welcome Joel from Phone.com, sponsor for today. You heard from Joel earlier, but we'd like to talk a little bit more about how Phone.com compares to some of the competition out there. So welcome, Joel.
Thank you.
So one of the things that we mentioned to Joel out in the hallway when we first met was that Joe and I both use RingCentral. I made the analogy to switching VoIP phone companies is like switching somebody who cuts your hair. The person who cuts your hair may not necessarily do a great job, but you never want to go to somebody who you don't know because you think like, oh, that person's going to really mess up my hair. So you end up continuing with, the devil that you know is better than the one that you don't. And maybe Joel can speak to that a little bit just in terms of putting everybody at ease. If you are thinking of switching to another VoIP phone company, certainly phone.com might be a solution for you. But one of the things that we shared with him was some of the pushback that we receive when either ourselves or we recommend RingCentral, and they have a referral program, to any of our clients, is that they have to deal with customer support and they try really hard, but it all comes out of the Philippines. And what immediately perked my ears up, and maybe Joel could speak to this a little bit more, is that all your phone support is US.
That is correct. It is all US. Bottom line is we have customer service people in San Diego, in Oregon, and in New Jersey. Some people may say New Jersey is another country also, but we do in fact have them all in the US, and that is for all sizes customers. One of the challenges with RingCentral is that if you have less than 35 users, you are getting support overseas. Now for larger companies, they do have US support, but only for those larger companies.
Interesting.
And where are you at now, Jerry? You're less than 35 at this point, right?
Less than 35 people in my company, yes.
Are we counting number of clients or number of... That is definitely the main pet peeve I have with RingCentral as well, is just the I will be promised a call back and it never comes, or I'll ask to speak to a supervisor and they're always in a meeting, it happens to be. So it's this frustrating thing where they run out the clock and I give up and then I don't end up getting the level of service that I'm paying for.
Well, to respond to that, I think there are a couple of points. First of all, RingCentral is a large company. They've got lots of folks, and they're going to be focusing on the highest, most profitable customers. We have 75 employees. We have 30,000 customers, but we believe that all of those customers are important. Many of our customers are very small. Some of them are sole proprietors. We do have larger customers, too. But one of the nice things about a company of this size is that if you have issues, you all now have my card, and we will get something done, and you will get a call back, and you will get your issue resolved.
Now, just in case anybody can't remember that complicated URL, what is it again?
Yes, I know, phone.com. And as I mentioned earlier this morning, the domain name came first. We built the company around it, and it has been very successful for us.
Fantastic. Awesome. Does anybody have any questions about phone systems to ask Joel while he's here?
Yeah, before we move on, just quickly, if this sounded interesting to me and I wanted to port my number,
sure.
Let's say from RingCentral,
yes.
How quickly can you get me up and running with phone?
Porting a number depends on the releasing carrier. It can take as little as 3 days or as long as a week or two. However, if you were to come to us, we would set you up with a temporary number. Mm-hmm. You'd still have your existing number working through that service. And when the port completed, it would automatically go through. So there will be no downtime whatsoever. One other thing you didn't ask, if any of these folks want to be a channel partner, they can be up and running within a day. So very, very quick.
Very nice.
That's an awesome counterpoint to the experience I had once again with RingCentral, where I had a client that we were suggesting their service to, and we initiated the process of getting the referral program, and they, again, ran out the clock. The client got onboarded, and then they said, we'll make it right, we'll take care of it. Never got taken care of. So it's really nice to be able to pick up the phone and call you and
sure.
Say, can you please take care of this?
Well, and even if I am not available, I have a team of folks that will back me up. Jason, who was here with me, is one of them. I have a woman that works with us that is outstanding at doing onboarding and helping agents. So we believe very strongly in customer support.
Excellent.
Do you guys have a soft phone? And can you talk about the features that the soft phone supports versus a hard phone?
So Andy's question is, do you have a soft phone? And can you talk about the features of that versus a hard phone?
Yes, the answer is actually yes and yes. We do have a soft phone. We currently are private labeling a company called Counterpath or Bria. And use that, but we're replacing that with our own version that will come out probably late summer. It's got full features. It's got your address book. It's got everything that you would expect to be in there.
Conference transfer.
Yes, all of that is in there. And in fact, you didn't ask this, but we also have iPhone and Android apps as well that are fully featured. And in fact, they will allow you to establish a conference call that's audio or even a video conference call through the smartphone app. Does the soft phone app have to be active for it to ring? And I believe the answer to that is yes. If I understand it, when we ship hardware to a customer, we will pre-provision it so that it's ready to go. I believe your question is, once we've done that, is it incapable of carrying anything else? Is that correct? The answer is no. We don't do that.
Great. Joel, thank you very much for sponsoring Command Control Power. We've got all kinds of stuff we need to share, so we'll move this segment along. But thank you again for coming up and answering some questions. And Joel, of course, will be out in the hallway today, tomorrow. So if you have any more specific questions that were triggered by this
conversation,
you could talk to Joel out in the hall. Thank
you,
Joel.
My pleasure. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Joel.
Thank you. Thanks, Joel. Thanks. Phone.com.
We just got word, I got a buzz in my ear from Justin that Mike from Origin 84 says hi all the way from across the world. So we want to shout out to him on Mixer.
Out in Australia.
Yeah.
Wow, fantastic. For this next little segment of the show, I have some exciting news to share. This is an exclusive announcement for the ACES conference here. So forgive my notes, I just wanted to be prepared for this. So first, some background. I've been an Apple consultant for 15 years. A lot of you probably know from listening to the show. I was a one-man show for a long time, and I've kind of taken the last 6 years or so to build up the practice. I faced a decision about 6 years ago, do I do that? Do I go down that path, or do I scale back? Do I maybe raise my rates significantly, scale back to become more of a boutique consultancy? And the decision came down to quality of life. When I went away on vacation, when it was just me, I was doing support with my phone. And back then I was also doing a lot of just guiding people remotely. There weren't a lot of remote management tools and things I could use. And so I just decided I wanted to be able to go away and have my clients be taken care of. I wanted to be able to have a team of people to cover for me when I wasn't around, or just in general to have that work-life balance that we talked about earlier. So I decided to scale the company. I decided to hire a operations manager, a technical person, open an office. So now 6 years later, that's where I'm at. I have an amazing operations manager. I have a senior consultant who's practically a clone of me. I have a really high quality team of people managing our clients and keeping them very well satisfied.
So your total staff right now, Joe,
it's
is how many?
Five and a half, basically, five full-time.
Including
myself. You know, my urge to travel all along has really been there in the background as I've been building my business, and I've had really good fortune to be able to take some amazing trips along the way. It got me thinking, what if I could take the show on the road? What if I could travel full-time? So, my big announcement, after a lot of planning and a lot of work transforming my life, my whole business, my wife Ashley and I have decided to move into a small camper van and travel the United States while working remotely.
In a van down by the river.
Basically. It will occasionally
you
be
You may
down
have
by
heard
the river.
Of it, yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
So yeah, that's the big announcement. Pretty significant life change, and it's been an incredible process of getting from point A to point B, starting about 2 years ago when this kind of seed was planted, and over the last year, really like working on this in earnest, actually since the last ACES, since ACES of last year. And it's just been an amazing process of like getting to this point. We leave in less than 2 weeks.
Now, we need to know more.
Okay.
So first of all, you were a double income, no kids, right? And Ashley had a viable employment, right? She was a school teacher.
So she's a trained educator. She's has her master's in teaching. She was teaching in the school system, teaching English. She then got certified in yoga. She was teaching yoga to kids, yoga and mindfulness, basically, to kids that would benefit from these things. So she's been kind of taking the educator mindset and the yoga instructor mindset and merging those together. But that involves being in the classroom. So she very surprisingly got on board with this plan of actually uprooting our life and taking the show on the road, so to speak. And she then got a job for a company working remotely as well, working for a company who does curriculum for kids with anxiety and stress. She helps develop curriculum for them.
But she severed those relationships and you guys partnered and bought a motorhome, right?
That's right.
Joe's motorhome that he's going to be traveling around the country and made an appearance at ACES last year. Very quick, kind of very hush-hush.
We took a quick trip right after ACES, since we were in Phoenix last year, to see the Grand Canyon. So that was like a two-day trip. It was amazing, and I can't wait to just get back out there.
Yeah, so Ramey can vouch for Joe. He's telling the truth today.
Yeah, he's seen the evidence, yes.
So do you have a really big Wi-Fi antenna on top?
Yeah, so actually, that's a great question. Of course, that's one of the most exciting things to talk about on the show, for me, anyway.
There's no beds for it. Sam and I thought there'd be bunk beds in the camper for us, too, or in the motorhome.
They have a trailer for us.
We can tell you guys. So we have two antennas on top with, but I did this on one of the last little quick trips I took. Wires routed inside, running to PepLink or PepWave cellular router. So it has a AT&T and Verizon connections. And it's a bonded router, so you can actually have the combined bandwidth of both connections, or you can do like WAN smoothing to get the fastest possible speed or the lowest possible latency. I'm still working all of this out. It's really complicated, a little bit more involved than I thought. But the idea is to have really good VoIP so we can continue to do the show, and also talk to clients, which is kind of important as well.
He originally had the Al Franken outfit. When Al Franken was on Saturday Night Live, it was the backpack with the dish over his head. But
for those of you guys that don't know, we got to show you the picture at some point.
It's hysterical. One of our show notes.
Yeah, but I can tell you personally, Joe's been working on this for a really long time and working hard at it. It's not like just a whim decision that you made. And I know you said this already, but he planned for it. He built that staff, as you said, and really worked to have a core group of people under him and with him that could operate that business. And I will say, on a personal level, some of you guys know that listen to the show, we're in the same town. It's a bummer for me because he's in my town and we're not going to spend the same amount of time together, which is kind of a bummer. But I'm hoping to go visit him.
Definitely.
And Jerry, I hope you'll come with me,
absolutely.
Bud. But
absolutely, yeah. And it's a great adventure for everybody because Joe sort of hits the road, you're going to be able to follow this with the podcast and he'll be broadcasting, hopefully from a different location.
All different places.
Yeah, probably. Yeah. And you'll...
Undisclosed location.
Yes,
yeah,
of course.
Right.
Triangulate to his massive antenna.
Yeah, you can probably spot it from a while.
Steve,
yeah.
We have a website with where?
That's a great idea.
The journey, there will be.
So the question was, will Joe have a website?
Will we have a website to kind of map the journey?
Forget where the world is.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, we'll be doing some stuff online as well. I'm not a big social media person, but we'll be keeping a website for sure. So. Get in touch if you're interested, and we'll send you guys the link.
So, and you mentioned you're going to be on the road when, and what is your first target destination, or it's just, Jack Kerouac kind of thing?
The vehicle is in L.A. right now, so we are flying out to L.A. In less than 2 weeks, and then we just head north from there pretty much. The idea is to be in the Pacific Northwest for June and July, which is a beautiful time of year apparently there. And kind of hover around there for the summer. And then I guess the only other thing on the calendar is Burning Man, which is an awesome thing. Has anybody been to Burning Man? All right.
Charles has been there.
Why am I not surprised?
Yeah.
And then that's it. I mean, basically it's open-ended. We'll just be kind of wandering around the West mostly, I think, at this point. Any other questions, Alan?
Yeah, there are some people.
If I need a hardware replacement, will you come?
I can come to you, right. So Alan's question, right, yeah.
Liar.
Awesome. Yeah, I can be there within, 2 or 3 weeks, probably. hope you can wait that long.
Joe, you have an open invitation to see all of us up in Seattle.
Awesome, thank you.
Oh, nice.
Thank you.
Seattle, we got Kevin in Portland.
Very cool.
So you're just going to be parking in people's driveways the entire time is what you're saying.
Kind of, yeah. I mean, it is a small van, so we can just kind of...
You can visit Justin Esgar in New Jersey,
With the red velvet ropes and things. Yeah.
JD's back.
Are you going to write a book about your adventures and your charmed life?
Well, I write a book about my adventures and a charmed life. If it turns out to be a charmed life, then maybe I will.
Now, the only other thing I wanted to share, I was a little concerned that Joe was going to kind of like just bare his soul, but that seems to be like what we kind of do on the podcast sometimes. We probably say too much about our own personal lives, but it's a major undertaking, and I'm sure it'll be successful, but you know, you'll kind of be along with us to hear some of those trials
along
and tribulations,
yeah.
Where Tim calls you and there was a small fire in the office, Joe, that we need to tell you about.
We need you to come back. Yeah. So, well, thanks for letting me make this announcement to this awesome room of supportive people and this forum.
So, you just said thanks for letting you announce it. How have your clients taken this? Or are you just going to hit the road and not tell them you're not?
My clients?
Yeah, that's a great question. So the question is, how did the clients, how are they going to take this?
Thought about this pretty hard. Thought there's the chance you could just tell everybody with a big announcement, you know, this big surprise announcement. Probably freak a lot of people out, and a lot of people would come out of the woodwork and say, I need to see you right now before you go, and all this stuff. So instead, we identified about maybe total like 36 people. And I have a lot of residential clients, so it's like, you know, 36 sounds like a lot, but it's a lot of like people I see a couple times a year. And just letting them know, like as a courtesy, not to be surprised if they call and then it turns out Joe's nowhere near here anymore. So we just did that out of a courtesy, basically, and some of the bigger clients as well. But yeah, and then I think as time goes on, maybe we'll make an announcement in a newsletter, mention it, that for those that don't know, and hopefully they didn't notice that I'm not there, we'll fill them in at some point. So.
I think the show title could be Joe Has Left the Building.
Yeah, exactly.
I'm literally checking my phone because my phone rang 4 times while Joe was talking, and it's one of my employees needing some desperate help. And so I just texted him, I'm like, I'm kind of doing a live show right now. Can we talk in a little while? So I'll give you guys the scoop on that. He's actually doing a Synology migration, and I think he's in the weeds. So I'm sure any one of us could probably help.
You guys
him
mind
out.
Waiting for Sam
yeah.
to take care of that?
I need a computer and a good connection.
Right.
And while Joe was talking, I was getting emojis from my 10-year-old at home on the watch. So.
So we're going to do a t-shirt, a new t-shirt this year. Last year we brought the shirts, and that took some advanced planning, and who has time for that? So this year...
Not you. You're planning for your big trip.
I had time for this. Yes, the t-shirt is going to be... This is Jerry's idea. There's a great idea. Put all the supporters on the t-shirt. And there's an example of the shirt, I think, from Steve. From last year? Is that the one? That's the
original
one on
campaign.
Teespring right now.
Yeah.
If you go to our website, if you go to commandcontrolpower.com and you click on support, you'll go to
just
the Patreon
show
page.
Them
and you can see a photo of, like, I don't know, probably half of the people here with their shirt on last year, which was so amazing. I can't believe it was a year ago. It was pretty awesome. So we're going to do a shirt this year that has everybody's name on it, all the supporters with whose support we've been able to do this show.
We've been using Patreon, so when Joe's talking about the supporters, there's a place on Patreon. We have a page where you can pledge to support the show in different increments.
Right.
What would I need to do if I wasn't on Patreon supporting the show right now to get my name on that t-shirt?
What a great question.
And by the way, you can have either your name or your business name. So whatever way you want to float that.
Pledge at any level, and we're going to put your name on the shirt. If you pledge at the $25 level and up, you get a t-shirt for free as well. Thank you all so much. Almost everybody in this room is a supporter. We really, really appreciate that. It's the reason we've been able to do this for, you know, almost 5 years now. 5 years. It's kind of insane.
As a quick aside, by the way, probably the most common question I get asked about the show is, like, how do you guys do it week after week after week? It's not easy sometimes.
Yeah.
You know, finding the time in a busy schedule, working hard, doing what we have to do, and then just sitting down and being energetic and doing that. We were just talking with a couple of people about that earlier. 4+ years, almost 5, of doing that, and it's still fun.
Yeah.
We still like each other, which is great.
Thanks to your support. We hope you continue to support us. We invite you to support us if you haven't yet. And you'll get your name on a shirt this time around as well. And we hope to see you guys wearing the shirt next year.
And we have a closing date for that.
So June 1st, Friday, June 1st is the deadline.
Closing date for that.
To pledge on Patreon.
To get your name on the shirt.
Yeah, to support us and get your name on the shirt. I guess big announcement.
Yeah, another big announcement.
So after doing this show for almost 5 years now, like I said, thanks to the support of all of the patrons, we are deciding to go sponsor-free. Nothing against any of our sponsors. We love our sponsors. Watchman Monitoring, Alan is in the front row.
Yep.
Thank you so much for your support over all these years. Really, thank you. I mean, obviously, we're continuing to use the product. It's the best. So we're going to continue to talk about it for free now. But we really hope that community can continue to support us and step up to allow us to continue to do the show for the future. So thanks to all of our sponsors over all the years, and especially, like I said, to Watchman Monitoring for supporting the consulting community, because that's why we're all here today at ACES.
So that doesn't mean we may not have a vendor on the show. If we do have a vendor on the show, just about in all cases, when there's been an ad, we've told you it was an ad, or we had a sponsor. If we did have a vendor, we weren't receiving any remuneration for that. So that may continue. We may have a representative, hopefully from Synology soon, but Promise or something like that, but we're not receiving any money for that. And most of the time when we do open it up to having somebody on the show, it's because something we're really excited about. So I know we had a representative, Jelani Memory from Circle with Disney. Yeah, so we had them
Square with Disney.
And you know, we didn't receive any money for that, but we were really excited about that product and really wanted to get a representative on the show. So that may happen from time to time.
I was just gonna kind of piggyback on that with a recent show with Smith AI, and I enjoyed that. It was very informational, and not to mention his backstory with Apple.
Yeah, Smith AI is a product that I use. They're answering all my phone calls today, yesterday, and it really just takes a tremendous relief off of my shoulders. We don't receive any money from them at all, just something we like and we believe in, and we figured that it might be useful to some of you here.
It's always good to have some people that sound different from us from time to time.
Change the voices.
And they're also interesting people. I mean, it gets boring to listen to you two all the time. So it's great to have some different people out there. And I agree with you, Steve. The backstory from Smith at AI was amazing. It was really great to hear. And he was so open with us and friendly. And those are the type of interviews that we just love.
So if you haven't heard that show, it's from Justin Maxwell. So he appears and he talks about his company on one show. And then the very next episode, we give you his backstory when he used to work for Apple at a really exciting time.
If anybody has any suggestions on that note for guests that you know you haven't heard from in a while or haven't heard on the podcast at all, or just interesting people to reach out to, we'd love to hear them. Showtime.
So one of the things that we really enjoyed from last year, we'll open it up again, is we'll just do a little bit of an open mic. If you have anything that you want to tell everybody about, or tell a little bit something about your company or something you did or some sort of implementation, anything at all, it's completely wide open. We'll bring you up here and you can be on the show. Richard Wingfield to the rescue. Thank you, Richard.
No, I just had to thank you guys for, I'll assume I can maybe speak for a lot of us in also saving us a lot of money with our psychiatrist when we get to live through you the pain of talking about the really fun clients on some of those shows. So the informational shows are great, but I know I love the shows where you guys are just telling stories and I'm yelling at my car and at the podcast playing in my car going, how did he get my client? How did that happen? So anyway, to thank you guys for all of that as
thank
well.
Thank you.
Thanks, man.
Thank you.
Got any stories to share? Anybody out there want to share any stories? Come on up.
Richard's been on the show at least several times, so go back and check out those episodes because he brings some great content to listen to.
And while we appreciate what he said, and it's always so nice to hear all of that, but also, if you want to come up and talk about anything to do with you in particular and your business and what you've been through, that's a great thing to share as well. That's one thing that I've learned so much from this show, from all of you, all the smart people we've had on. We've learned about products, ways of doing business, contractual information from our friend David Sparks. And there's been a lot of good stuff that I've learned from the show and bettered my business because of it. So if you have anything you want to bring up about you guys, it doesn't have to be about us.
Alan Hancock from Watchman, I know you are speaking to us tomorrow, I guess, briefly?
Yes. Yep.
Yeah, so, but anything you want to share with us, like a little teaser for tomorrow? something in the pipeline, maybe, or something you're looking to? I don't mean to put you on the spot.
But you did.
For all of our Zendesk-using subscribers, go look at the private ticket creation feature. Make sure all your triggers are updated appropriately because it's a fantastic feature, but it needs preparation. And I don't want to have to teach everybody on it. So a little teaser of something that's coming.
That's great.
I know that Alan was really helpful in my implementation of that Zendesk integration with Watchman, and I've been using it ever since. I think I've been using Watchman. It's just been absolutely fantastic as a add-on.
Speaking of Zendesk, I switched from Zendesk to Repair Shopper, and it, you know, thanks to Watchman, it was really seamless. It's integrated with both options, and I literally just like flipped the switch, and now my tickets are going into Repair Shopper, and yeah, it was fantastic.
Adam Angst, everyone.
So, any event, this is completely unrelated to what we've been talking about before, but for our main tidbits newsletter, we've recently changed our entire internet infrastructure. And this is something I know, like, Steve Storbo is going through in terms of, like, you're bringing up a new website, new mailing list, all this kind of stuff. And I think the only piece of advice I'd like to say is that figure out how long you think it's going to take and then quadruple it. It's going to take a long, long time. It's going to be a ton of work, and you can't underestimate that. So, you know, whatever you think, add a lot more and be prepared to work, you know, hours and hours and hours extra when you actually bring stuff online. Yeah, home improvement, DIY on your website, yeah. I'm still hiring a developer, and even still it took too much. But be careful of that stuff, because we all do it periodically, right? You know, you'd be just like, oh, the website's really old, I should do this.
Let me dive right in. Yeah,
right. A lot more work than you think.
2 years later.
2 years would be nice.
Right.
Thank you, Adam.
Thank you.
Yeah. You got one more.
Yeah. Oh.
He's trying to cut
please,
you off.
Yeah.
I just wanted to thank you guys in general for all the stuff that you do. I've learned so many little tradecraft things from listening to you, and also enjoyed the, as he said earlier, the discussion of how you deal with clients, and it's cathartic. But I also wanted to thank you in particular for my favorite command control power trick. I think it was Sam, but it's the keyboard combination that you can use if you're remoting into somebody's computer and their screen lock is on, and you can hit, I don't know, what is it, command return or something that?
Command return.
Command return, right. And you can type in the admin password and you can unlock their screen and do what you have to do.
Yeah.
And that's awesome. Thank you.
Yeah. Cool.
Everyone's eyes just like open up.
Yeah. If anyone doesn't know about it, I'll reference the episode and I'll get you the URL, but it is a great little trick that basically allows you to unlock a user's account with your admin credentials, even when they've locked their screen.
And if anybody got the opportunity to hear Alex Narvi last year, he absolutely killed it at ACES with his presentation. So I still remember that. It was wonderful.
Yeah. Now, thanks, Alex.
Am I right in saying Alex and Alan are going to be doing a little face-off on... This is great. And for anybody listening at home, you can also buy the video to see this.
Yeah, let's
stuff,
talk about that
talking
again.
About things that are happening tomorrow, and if
well,
you're not here, you can't get here.
Before that, obviously, I want to thank you guys. You guys have been a big supporter of ACES also, which has been huge for me, letting me come on the show, do takeovers, tell everybody that I think Sam is the hottest man on radio and whatever, and it's fine.
It's because you can't see my face.
Exactly. thank you. This is the third year in a row we're doing this, and hopefully wherever we end up at ACES next year, the camper van will be able to make it so you guys can do this again. So
do
I want to appreciate
West,
it.
Please.
I make no promises. So real quick, for tomorrow, for anyone, and then we'll talk about the videos, we have a special marketing panel in the morning that's going to be hosted by Adam Angs. Take control of your time. Alex and Alan are going to be doing the great debate about pricing. Then Adam's going to be back up with minimum viable marketing. We're going to do a working lunch with Chris Weiser. He was here today talking about more marketing topics. I mean, this we're really marketing heavy this year. Later, Ryan Grimes, get out of your mom's basement and go meet people. And then our own Marcy Maslow is going to be talking about bookkeeping, accounting, and CPA. And then Jennifer Dawn will be closing it out with Get More From Year 24. And then if you are at home, if you're here, you have your coupon code, but if you're listening from home and you're not here, I think the coupon code is missed it, one word, and you'll get $50 off the video, and that expires on Friday. So you have to be listening live.
Listening live.
Michael in Australia.
But it's already expired for him, though. That's the problem.
That's good. That's true. And then whenever this...
I haven't heard that joke before.
And then when this gets caught up and goes live on the website, it'll be $2.99 for the videos, and you'll get to see all the amazing content that you missed out being here live. And again, thank you guys. CCP guys, they're amazing, right?
God, thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, all of you.
Yeah, I got a couple of quick things because I know we don't want to keep anyone from their food and or drink. But this is a little bit out of order for people that may be not listening live or in the audience, but if some of you know, I recently got Office Space, which was a big discussion we had internally and also had as a group. And I clearly remember being at ACES, I think it was 2 years ago at ACES, and I was having this very discussion, should I get space, should I not get space? And I actually clearly remember Charles Edge walking up to the front, making all the cases why I should not get Office Space. And here I am, I signed the lease, Charles.
You mentioned you'd be getting stabbed by needles, right? Discarded needles, right. In razor blades, razor wire,
liability from
it. Yeah, so there are a lot of good reasons either way, but as of today, we've signed a year lease, which is a big deal for me and for my staff. So it's a pretty cool thing. I just wanted to share it with everyone here.
Congratulations.
Who knows, next year I could come back to ACES and be like, that's out, I'm done, I'm back in my dining room. Yeah, I'm in Joe's camper traveling around. Great show, guys, as always.
Thank you all for being here.
Yeah, thanks, everybody.
We'll see you.
See you all soon.
Thanks again.
Yeah, thank you.
Deeply detailed yarns all the time.
I have a whole story about this.
Sam is on.